Where's my wife?
Are you sure she did not pass through this gate?
Yes, our guy, it is very, very locked. You can even go and check it. It's very, very locked.
What is going on?
Just relax, eh? Calm down. Let me look for your wife everywhere in this compound. Your wife cannot get lost under my watch. As long as I, Erasmus, is still your personal security officer, your wife cannot get lost. Now just calm down. Let me search.
Amara! What kind of mystery is this? Amara!
Yeah, okay. Are you sure my wife did not pass through this gate last night?
Oga, I swear with my father's grave of 1990, nobody don't pass through this gate, not even your wife. See, Amna, the gate is still very, very locked.
My room was also locked when I started looking for her. What kind of mystery is this?
Oga, I beg, no vessel, but before you marry this woman, you sabi her very, very well.
What sort of question is that?
Just that this thing, they remind me of something what happened for my village long time ago. One man like that will marry one fine woman. She even fine pass madam. After traditional marriage ceremony, the woman just disappear. Fiam! We find her round the whole village. Nobody see her. Nobody knows her ghost.
Wait, Erasmus.
Sir.
Are you saying my wife could be a ghost?
Sir, I didn't say so. But if you reason and well, there's way fit appear, disappear, appear, disappear. Wait till you won't call her.
What do I do now? Should I call the police? What do I tell them happened to her? Who would believe that the wife I just got married to disappeared into thin air? Just like that! No. No one will believe me. People will accuse me of using her for money ritual. What do I do now, God? But the question still remains, how did she get out of this house with everywhere locked. Are you sure Amara is not a ghost? Where are you coming from? What happened? Talk to me. Where are you coming from? Amara. Talk to me.
I need to take a shower first.
Okay, fine. You can go upstairs and take a shower. We'll talk about it later.
Find any of my belongings.
How?
I mean, I can't find my jewelries, my shoes, my bags, my clothes.
What do you mean you can't find any of your belongings? What?
What are you talking about? What sort of talk is that?
I should be asking you that question. What's going on?
Really? I am the one to explain to you about the strange happenings in a house you've been living in for years.
I have never experienced any strange happening in this house since I bought it. So you start explaining to me what is going on here.
What are you insinuating?
Where were you last night? How did you even manage to leave this house while every single door in this building remained locked?
Oh, please don't get it twisted. I am not a kid. You either tell me the truth or this marriage will be over. And right now.
What truth are you talking about?
That's the very first night in my husband's house. I slept on the same bed with him and woke up in- Now all my belongings are gone, and presumably to that same refuse dump. Obiora, you better start talking, because I need an explanation right about now.
Who is that?
Oga, I'm here, Erasmus.
Hey, what is it?
Oga, you get some bags and clothes where I see outside the gate. They resemble the one where Madame Carrie called yesterday.
What are you?
I passed through this gate a few minutes ago and this thing's wearing tear.
I'm confused. What's going on here? Eh?
I'm getting more scared. This thing's wearing tear. I am sure of what I'm saying.
Erasmus.
Sir?
Pack the things back into the house. Pack the bags into the house! You're not the one that dropped these things here.
Sir, I don't know anything about this, sir. I swear.
Hurry up and shut that gate.
Yes, sir.
Thank you.
worrying over this. I don't know what's going on, but I promise you I'll get to the bottom of this mystery. Okay? Just stop worrying.
How can you possibly tell me that you do not know what is happening in a house you've been living in for years now?
Honestly, I don't. I've never experienced this kind of thing since I moved into this house. That's why I'm baffled.
Why now? Why is it happening now? Now that I just got in, why?
I wish I knew. I'm suspecting maybe someone somewhere is trying to manipulate us. Trying to do stuff that will break us apart. But like I said before, I promise you to get to the bottom of this. And all of this will be a thing of the past, okay? It's okay, honey. Stop worrying. Really going on? What could be responsible for all those mysterious happenings? The worst is that my wife thinks I know something about them. Oh, God, please help us. Help my marriage. It is too tender to face this kind of challenge.
Okay, I'll be there in 10 minutes. Alright.
Nonsense is this? Eh? Since when this woman entered this compound, everything don't turn jaga jaga. Eh? Which kind of obanje woman be this? Of all the women we did this one, and this one, that this obanje woman, I Oga go marry. So she don't know where it was been there again. Can this thing pour for here?
Oh.
Who is there?
Madam Erasmus.
Coming.
Madam, I greet you.
I see your pot for outside. Madam, if not the food I see for outside though, make I go pack them. I see her for outside, madam. I see her for outside. Exactly where it was.
Exactly this place.
Yes, madam, I am very, very sure. Madam,
open the dust for me.
Hey, madam, not the rice with this. Not the rice.
Who put it in here?
Madam, I don't know. I don't know. Jesus! Madam. Is everything all right?
Everything is not all right, and you know it. So quit pretending, because I am fed up.
Honey, calm down and explain to me exactly what you mean.
What do you want me to explain? Since I stepped into this house, I have not had a moment of peace. It's been from one horror to another. You don't want to imagine what I've been through in less than 24 hours. I am tired.
Calm down, honey. Please calm down. Myself, I'm just like a bird in a cage. I don't know where all these are coming from.
Something is wrong in this house. There is a spirit being living here. A female. I saw her.
You saw what?
A ghost! I saw her at the backyard, and before I could utter a word, she had disappeared. I know what I'm talking about. I am not hallucinating.
This is getting serious.
Let's run away. Let's relocate somewhere. Let's just relocate somewhere and get a flat. It's better to live in a flat in peace than living in this haunted mansion of ours.
I honestly have never seen any mysterious thing around this house since I moved in here. But I need you to be at peace. So I will buy a new house. And you and I will move in there. But I can't do it immediately. Just exercise patience for like a month or so. Okay?
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome. Take care of yourself, okay? Make sure nothing bothers you.
I'm still afraid.
You don't have to be. Okay, you have no reason to be scared. Just have faith that nothing will happen and you'll be fine.
I am scared. What if that's strange?
Shh. Nothing strange will happen here today. Just have faith. That's it. Repeat after me, babe. Nothing strange will happen in this house today.
Nothing strange will happen in this house today.
That's my baby. So you go about your normal duties. Go into the kitchen, make your favorite meal, sit on the couch here, see movies, have fun generally. In no time, I'll be back. Okay?
Okay.
Alright. Why don't you see me to the car?
Okay. Have a blessed day.
And you too.
Thank you.
Stop worrying.
Thank you.
I hallucinating? Am I hallucinating? I can't be the only one seeing her. Insane. I can't be the only one seeing her. Erasmus!
Ma?
Come. Go in there and get me my phone.
Where, madame?
In my room. No, in the living room. It's on top of the table.
Yes.
Thank you. Did you see anyone inside?
Is anyone supposed to be there?
No. You can't go back to your duty post.
Madame. Are you sure everything is all right?
Yes, but you said there is no one in there. You didn't see anyone?
No, there's nobody. Nobody.
You can go back to your duty post. I can't be the only one seeing her. I have to call my cousin, I have to call Adobe. Hello, Adobe.
Hello there. How are you?
I'm not fine. I need to see you now, please.
Now?
Yes, now. Now.
What is it? Can't we talk it over the phone?
I'm out of town and I'll be back in 2 days' time.
Hey! In 2 days' time?
Yes, Amara. You sound tensed. What is the problem?
It's not something we can discuss over the phone. Oh, not to worry, when you're back, I'll wait.
Okay. Please, my dear, whatever it is, just calm down, okay? Alright?
Alright, bye.
your dala, buy your dala. Dala means, dala means, dala means.
Madam, fresh gala, fresh gala.
It's me, my man. Obiora! My man!
My man!
Look at you!
Hey! Obiora! Look at the color! Hey, my man! My brother! You have changed, you have changed.
It's God, thank God. How have you been?
I'm fine. This is your car.
Well, this is one of my cars.
Hey! One! Ibu taki keki basu! Ibu taki keki basu! One keke nemezim kejesi! How come?
It's not something I can explain to you on the street. What will happen is I'll give you my card, you give me a call, we'll sit down somewhere cozy and talk. You need to stop doing this.
Abi.
Yeah, or better still, you come visit me in my house. So you can as well meet my wife.
Are you serious? Uh-huh. You're married.
I'm happily married.
You're married?
Yes.
Hey! Hey! My manchi! You know, look, can we kiss
you? Don't worry, yeah?
Chupa, go, zikoki!
Hey! Okay. So here is my card. Give me a call and then I will direct you on how to get to my house.
You don't have a problem.
And this is for you. You need to stop doing this, but come over to the house and talk better.
Hey!
My brother, thank you.
You're welcome.
I need to run along now. I have somewhere to go, but we shall see and talk about this.
Hey!
Odogwu!
Nwanne!
I think I'm
going to be in there. Hey, don't look at your
thank you. Who is that?
Oh, brother, good morning.
Good morning. I'm an IAP.
I won't see my friend Obiora.
Which Obiora?
The one way tall, fair, you get body.
Oh, you get one carpenter way there down the street there. Tall, fair, you get body.
My brother, wait,
wait. Okay, wait, you won't break my gates.
Wait. Don't be here, be number 3, Isiara Street, Oliver Avenue.
Hey,
now you ain't give me the address, now you ain't tell me.
Wait. You mean say, Nama Oga give you this address?
Yes. Obiora Ejike, my friend. My man.
Okay, let me inform you.
Okay.
What it also be your name?
Siriakus.
Siria.
Just tell us Sisi, you know.
Sisi. Yeah. I'll come and see.
Hey! Hey, Uchimo! So now, Obiora, where me and I'm the whole gala 4 years ago, get this kind big house. See house? See car? Hey! But how come? How did Obiora make this kind big money within a short period of time? No condition is permanent, though.
Maoga say, make you come inside.
Thank you.
Welcome, please make yourself comfortable. Yes?
This is where you live.
This is my house.
Wanne, this is paradise on earth.
Sorry, what do I offer you, Biko?
Want anything, anything, I go there.
Okay, food then. My wife will be here shortly so she can arrange something for you to eat.
Obiora, you no lugo kawo kesi ano. Alu banye go gini fan alu. I can't believe it's Obiora I was hawking gala with 4 years ago that you are now a billionaire.
I give God the glory. You know, after I stopped hawking, I started driving a taxi I had on hire purchase. In fact, that taxi nearly drove me back to the village. What is it?
I saw her.
You saw who?
The ghost.
Will you shut up?
She's in our room making our bed. I wanted to go take a shower before she had...
Can you shut it? Can you not see we have a visitor? Won't you coordinate yourself?
I said I saw her.
Can you not coordinate yourself and shut up with a ghost story? What sort of rubbish ghost story is that? Now come and show me the ghost you said you saw. Go ahead and show me the ghost you said you saw. Sorry, I'll be with you in no time, okay? Don't feel embarrassed. I'm sorry about this.
She's in my room.
Come and show me the ghost you said you saw.
I beg, move this, Oga. Open the gate.
Open which gate? What did you do, my Oga?
I swear, I know.
What is that, my Oga?
I know that many people, your mother and the shark ghost.
Hey! Ghost! Ghost for where? For this house?
Where is the ghost? Amara, where is the ghost?
I saw her. She...
Will you shut up before I give you a death slap? Are you about to embarrass me before my friend? Do you know what you did? Why are you like this? Are you possessed? By the way, why are you the only one who sees this ghost? Why haven't I seen it? Why has Erasmus not seen this ghost? Does that not tell you that your little brain needs deliverance? Instead of you to go and seek a solution to what's happening to you, you're here trying to seek someone to tarnish his image. Don't you ever try this again. Nonsense.
Wahala we are both sir. Wahala we are both sir. Come. Imagine Obiora. Innocent looking Obiora went and soiled his hands with blood money. Hey! Obiora, you forgot. Of what use is money? Tell me. Of what use is money if you don't have rest of mind to sit and enjoy that money? Of what use is money now? Just look at my guy. Nezienu, my guy, as he's running up and down, ghost is chasing him up and down in his own house. His wife does not have rest. He does not have rest. And I am sure that the ghost that is chasing him around is the ghost of the person he killed for his money ritual. Hi! God forbid! I want money, but I don't want this kind of money. Huh? I know I need money. But you see this money? I'm not going to eat this money. I will not eat this money because I don't want to soil my hand with any blood-stained money. I know I am not yet a billionaire, but at least I have rest of mind. So first thing tomorrow morning, this morning, I am going to burn him. Unga ogo oko. Let me hand solve this evil. I don't want any ghost to come here chasing me around because of money. Look, no, man. Hey! Fear, Pago. Fear, Pago, man. I hope this evil Obiora did not give me this money in exchange for my good destiny. Wala wea books are come. Wala wea okrika books are come. I'm not burning this money. I am taking this money to the church first thing tomorrow morning. Eh? For prayers. Any evil way this guy don't plan against my good destiny. Hey! My destiny, my bright future. Future where I don't see how I go America come back. Future where I don't see how I take sit down with senators, president, they talk. This guy won't Tanisha. This guy won't collect her. This guy won't collect my bride destiny with ordinary chicken 100,000. Obiora, Chineke ga ogo oko. God will punish you. Tell him tomorrow. Obiora, tell him tomorrow. Tell him tomorrow.
as they are burning this money in the church tomorrow, anywhere you are, Oga won't be there. Anywhere you are, Obiora, Oko, you've never seen anything. The ghost that is chasing you around is just a small thing. The fire that will consume you tomorrow, one day, it's a man, but I don't have a baby. Eh? You don't want to go to one day. If you need him, Kajina, if you need him, Kajina, give me a little bit of piano. The fire that will consume you tomorrow, Obiora, it can put another and all kind of feeling special. One day, they are going to phone you, and I know they were. No phone you, they were Australian. What? Wait for me! You will hear that.
Erasmus! 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 I'm calling you Erasmus!
Ah, so?
What? Are you talking to me?
Who are you? I said, who are you? Oh, so because I have been calling you madam all this while, your head has been swelling. Eh? I'm a cat like you. See, the next time you call my name Erasmus without the respect, I will teach you a lesson you never forget in your life.
Is this some kind of joke or what?
So nobody told you that your mouth is stinking. Your teeth is smelling. Brush your teeth now, madam. Brush your teeth.
Huh? You know what? I have had it up to here. I would have sacked you right away, but wait until my husband comes.
Which husband? Do you have a husband? Which man in his right senses will marry an Obaje like you? Erika Akuna like you? Oh, you think because you are fair, you're using your compassion to deceive them? Obaje with international passport? Or you think you have caste? Because your father is from Abatete and your mother is from Abeokuta? See, by the time I finish with you, you know that me, Erasmus, I'm the chief security officer of this compound. I was here before you. Ask everybody the one of Olive Avenue. Nobody that does not know Erasmus, the chief security officer. You better start packing your things. Because if I decide to do it for you, you will regret it. Nonsense!
I can't take this anymore. I can't. Will
you stop there, you fool? This is your last warning. Better leave this house in peace. Else, I will force you out in pieces. Be warned. Be warned!
Holy Ghost fire! 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 I cover myself with the precious blood of Jesus. I cover every corner of this house with the precious blood of Jesus Christ. Holy Ghost fire! Holy Ghost fire! Consume them! Consume them! Consume them! Father, consume them! Wherever they are! Wherever they are gathering! Wherever she is! Holy Ghost fire! Consume them! Wherever they are gathered! Wherever he is gathered, wherever she is gathered, Father, don't consume him. Consume her. Consume them. Holy Ghost fire. Blood of Jesus Christ. Blood of Jesus Christ. Blood of Jesus Christ. Consume them. Consume them.
One by wago, one by wago, one by one by wago, one by abutife ya neba. Nne wamba wago wamba na nne wamba wago wamba na nne wamba wago wamba ya butife ya neba na nne wamba wago wamba ya butife ya neba.
There's a strong evil force in your house that is responsible for the stretch happening in your home.
Strong evil force. Hezenwine,
I want that evil force destroyed so I can live in peace in my house with my wife.
Nane wamba wago wamba, nane wamba wago wamba. Nane wamba wago wamba, yabu tife ya neba. Nane wamba wago wamba, yabu tife ya neba. Nane wamba wago wamba, nane wamba wago wamba, nane wamba. Wago wamba yabu tife ya neba. Nane mamba wago wamba yabu tife ya neba. Nne wamba wago wamba nane wamba wago wamba. Nne wamba wago wamba yabu tife ya neba.
Bury this in your compound, and the evil spirits will never come in there again.
Thank you, Ezamai. I will do as you have said.
Go in peace.
Thank you. Ezamai, this is for the gods.
God of Elijah, send on fire. 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 God of Elijah. God of Elijah, send the fire. Holy, my son. I see a cloud of darkness covering you. Your friend is an occultic man. Yes. He trades on people's destiny.
Hey!
Holy.
I said it, Obiora, I knew that guy, not the committed.
Yes.
Please help me and retrieve my good and wonderful destiny.
I will help you, my son. Thank you. How much did he give you?
Come on, 100,000.
100,000.
1 year ago.
Are you with the money yet? Holy. Drop it in the white bowl. I hope it's complete.
I did not remove Fatim from the money.
Okay.
It's complete.
The money is evil. Anointed. Only. Stretch forth your hand and I will pray for you. I will retrieve your destiny.
Holy.
From the kingdom of the occultic. Holy. Receive. In the name of Jack, receive your destiny. Holy angel. Sakaba. Receive your destiny.
Amen.
Receive.
Amen.
Receive it.
Amen.
My child, you are set free. Go and shine.
Amen. Amen.
Eli.
Amen.
It is settled.
Amen.
Stand up. Go and shine.
Amen.
God of Israel.
Amen.
Land on fire.
God of Elijah! Holy! Holy!
Water press the fire.
No,
okay, if I'm only there, make a bring water.
Get out of here, leave me alone. Erasmus.
Sir?
Where's my wife? Erasmus.
Sir?
Where's my wife?
Oga, she come out since morning. She didn't tell me where she was going.
Since morning?
Yes, sir.
Hello?
Hello.
Where are you?
I'm at my cousin's place.
Since morning till now?
I'm not coming back to that house.
How? What do you mean?
I have seen so much in just a few days. I am not coming back to that house. I do not want to die here. Please.
Thank you.
happening? What's going on? What's all this? All I ever wanted was to have a sweet and happy home. How did I marry the wrong woman?
Yes, now. That woman. I'm very sure she's an Obanje. Since she come out, see us everywhere, they're quiet and peaceful. Eh? I don't even know how Oga take marry this Obanje woman. In that parking, go back to her village people before she go use my Oga for sacrifice. Eh? But I keep asking myself, of all the women in this world, why be say, now this Obanje woman, my Oga marry?
Because he knows what I'm talking about. He's only pretending.
Calm down, Amara. Calm down. The truth means that you're not sure. There's a possibility that your husband does not know anything about the strange happenings in your house.
No, 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 no. I beg to disagree. I mean, he's been living in that house for years now. You can't tell me he isn't aware that there are strange forces in that house. Like I said earlier, I am not going back there. I do not want to die young.
Running away from your home is not the best way to conquer. I mean, you need to put hands with your husband and fight for your marriage. Because if you don't, nobody will do it for you. Not even me. Your dinner is ready.
You want from me?
What I want from you?
Yes. What do you want? I did everything I was required to do. So why are you here?
You know why I'm here.
I don't know why you are here. So tell me.
Really? Do I owe you an explanation for being here? My presence here is legal. Before man, and before all the deities that govern the spirit world. You brought me here. And I will never share this place with another woman. Never!
What is this? What have I done? How did I get into this trouble? What is all this now? Because, eh?
Money!
Okay, landlord. Good morning, sir.
Keep that, your useless duty! Keep it! What is good money, sir? Where is my money?
Okay, landlord. Please. Next week I go bring the money call
you. Thunder fire you! Thunder fire you! Is it not the same thing you told me last 3 weeks? You told me the same thing last week. And you are telling me today. Look at me. Am I your mate? If you don't pay me my money now, I will do something to you that you will never forget in your life.
Oga landlord, I beg. I beg. Just give me next week. I will give you the money.
I'm not leaving here until you pay me my money. How can you be living in someone's house for 2.5 years without thinking of payment? Is that not wickedness? You are heartless!
Okay, Lord, I beg, I beg, I beg. It's not intentional. Eh? But please, forgive me and give me this last chance. Eh? Next week I will pay you. Is it not 75,000? I will pay you next week. I swear. I swear. If I don't pay you next week, anything where you like, do to me.
Now listen. I'm giving you 3 days. 3 days. If I come back and you do not pay me my money, you will not like me.
If you call the if idiot. Let him come.
$100,000 Ichikom I would have used to pay my house rent and even get change. I can't go dash prophetess in the name of retrieving stolen destiny. Which destiny, self? Which destiny? I get destiny as I did so. I get future. I get hope. Common house rent. I know fee pay. Common 75,000. I know fee pay. I get future. For the past 6 years, I did this town. I did this town, the hustle under the sun, the hot gala. No improvement. No improvement. Rather, my condition is getting worse. Yes, now. I don't say my condition better 6 years ago. Pass now. My God. God, 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 God. Which kind of nonsense mistake be this? Which kind of mistake? Which kind of move mistake be this?
Eh? Even if I call people once see this, this is my kind of thing they go see.
What did they go use and do? What did they go use and do? I could go collect that money. That prophetess, she will give me back that money. She go give me my 100,000 Ichikom. At least I go use and pay house rent. Which one be this one? Make your call people. Make they take the destiny. Obiora and his group. Take the destiny. Prophetess, go give me back my 100,000 Ichikom. You can use and pay house rent.
My brother, that is what I saw with my own 2 eyes. I'm still confused at the moment.
I have not heard this kind of story in my life before. It sounds like fairy tale.
Exactly. When my wife told me about it, it sounded like a fairy tale until I saw with my own eyes.
Did you tell your wife you have seen the ghost too?
No, I didn't tell her. She's not in town at the moment.
Okay.
I really need a strong spiritual help.
Yeah, you seriously need help.
I'm still trying to figure out what she meant by she wouldn't share my house with another woman.
Ask your wife or what?
Ask me, my brother.
Ha. This is serious.
Ask me which one and them more.
It sounds funny, but it's serious.
Destiny, give you to the occult man and hand over my 100,000 to me.
Which 100,000 are you talking about? Angels have carried the money. Don't carry and go heaven.
Eh? Angels have carried my own 100,000 naira.
Yes.
Who called the angels make the con carry the money?
I did.
Thank God you said the truth.
I prayed and they come carry the money.
Fine. Pray again. Then they say, make them bring back my 100,000. Want to use it for something very important.
Oh, why am I even discussing this here with you? Eh? Will you leave my temple before I turn you to a rat right now?
Ah, madam, you don't want to finish, eh? You don't hire and you won't change that for me. Madam, I know they see your face. You see, eh? If you don't give me that 100,000 naira now, if you don't give me that money now, I will scatter this nonsense place to call them. I will put everything here down.
Calm down, my son. You know you need the destiny more than
you. Madam, are you the one to tell me what I need? Madam, are you going to tell me what I need? Madam, give me my money. Calm. Give me my money. I want it all. I'm going to change that for you. Give me my money.
I beg, my son. Calm down. Eh? Don't come and scatter my business, my temple. Eh? Even if you scatter this place, you will not see any money, eh? I'm using it to pay my children's school fees, please.
Eh? So not the time to carry the money again. You carry and pay your children's school fees. And I give you money. Give me my money! You the dress, I'm going to tell you!
I'm going!
Call you! Give me my money! Give me my money! Give me my money!
Please help me. I'm confused. I love my husband so much. And I miss him too. But I can't go back to that house. No. I can't. Oh, please God, help me. Help us save our marriage. It's way too tender to face this kind of crisis. Please help us.
You start with me.
I think you should go see my pastor. I believe his prayers will help out.
Please, I am ready to do anything just about now to see my husband. I miss him. I miss him. I want to be with him.
I understand. Okay? His counseling day is a day after tomorrow. Yes.
A day after tomorrow. Okay, fine. I'm ready. I hope he can deal with that evil spirit.
Definitely. He's a very powerful man of God. Don't worry, you'll see things for yourself.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
It's okay.
I'm scared.
I hate to see you like this. Please.
I'm scared. I'm so scared.
Grandmaster of Izama, the seven-breasted goddess of the hidden reaches of the dark places of the earth. I worship. Here is my friend Syriacus. He is tired of life. He is tired of living in abject poverty, so he has come for help. He is willing to sacrifice anything to the goddess in exchange for riches and a good life. I greet you, Grandmaster.
Young man, are you sure you are truly tired of poverty?
Yes, sir.
Grandmaster.
Grandmaster.
Are you sure you are ready to sacrifice anything for riches?
Grandmaster, I am ready to sacrifice anything for riches.
Is that my request for the soul of your girlfriend, Eliza?
Eliza. Grandmaster. So if I sacrifice her, the spirit of Izama will give me riches.
Izama, the seven-breasted goddess of wealth and affluence, will turn you into a billionaire as soon as you sacrifice her soul.
No problem. I will bring her for sacrifice.
So this money ritual thing, is this easy? Yay! I was even thinking they would demand for my mother or my lovely sister. Or pull out that foolish, stupid, senseless, idiotic Eliza. I have given her to them. I have given her to them. In fact, tomorrow morning I am going to Biora's house. I will tell him that I am ready for morning ritual. He should take me to their occult temple. As long as the person they will demand for me is that nonsense girl. One day I am in for the ritual. I'm not looking at one case here now because this poverty. Poverty has dealt with me, and enough is enough. Tomorrow now, this my troublesome jobless landlord will come here and start disturbing my life. I have to end it now.
My man.
Syriacus. How are you doing?
I'm fine.
Welcome.
Thank you.
Welcome. You can sit.
My man. I beg you. Please. I am very sorry the way I ran away to your daddy. I am really sorry.
No. I know who should apologize for embarrassing you in my own house. Get up. Get up and sit. Sit down. It's okay.
Thank you. You're really a brother.
What do I offer you now that you have enough time?
Just forget about it. I don't I don't want to waste time.
You can't come to my house and not want to take anything. I hope all is well.
Udo, all is well. The only challenge I have is that help you promised to help me the other time. I have thought about it. I have made up my mind. I am ready. So that is why I came.
I see. That's a good one. I even forgot. Okay, let me go straight to the point. I will have you go learn a trade or a business, any one of your choice. Within 6 months to a year, come back to me and I'll give you money to set up your own business.
Odogu, Odogu, I am not talking about business. I don't mean kumaka buying and selling. Eh? What I am saying is that nini dimi boutique. Alo bani go gini fana alo. Mwa choke lo bani mini fana alo. Kano lo kamo kiti ano. Please, show me the way. I am ready.
I don't understand what you mean by that. That's why I'm asking you to go learn a trade so I can sponsor you. That's the way.
Obiora, why are you talking as if... Why are you talking as if you don't understand what I'm saying? Eh? You know what I'm saying? Listen, eh? Whatever the occult people will demand, I am ready to give them anything they will demand, offer anybody they will demand. Please, take me to your occult temple. Let them initiate me. Fe bunye mi ke kan look awon kesi ano.
Wait a minute. What secret occult temple are you talking about? Are you in any way insinuating I'm a ritualist?
Ubiora, I am not a baby. I am not a child. I'm a mifana. I'm a nidigo committed. I know. How would you explain the ghost story your wife was telling the other day? I know that story is related to ritual or wego, a bani boutique. So I want you to take me there. Come boutique, let me be a billionaire.
You must be insane to think I'll soil my hands to be a member of such very dirty organizations.
Biorabiko, help me.
Look at this idiot I was planning to give 5 million naira to start his own business. Coming to accuse me of being a ritualist, really?
You want to give me 5 million?
Get out of my house and never to be seen here again.
My man, I am sorry.
I said get up and get out of my house.
Please forgive me, just give me the fact.
Get out of my house and get out of my house. Out! Let me not ever see you here again.
Please, you need to give me the 5 million.
5 million, bogey dear. Get out of my house! Idiot! Oh, you think everybody who's comfortable is a ritualist, right?
That is what you have to do, my sister. You see, he needs you now more than ever. You have to stand by him until this battle is over. Do not relent in your prayers. Because the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty true God. To the pulling down of strongholds.
I will do as you've said, Pastor. Thank you.
May the Lord strengthen you.
Amen.
Let's have a word of prayer.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Ancient of Days, the chariot of Israel, unto thee shall the gathering of your people be. They have come before you. Father, we are standing at the feet of our Master Jesus.
That's
me, the devil's power you can't help me. Leave me alone now. Leave me alone. Let me be in this life. I am human and you are a spirit. The living and the dead have nothing in common. That will no matter. What is this?
Why? Why do you always remind me of my body, which has decayed beneath the earth? I lost it because of you.
No, you lost it out of your own carelessness, not because of me. if you did not plan!
Please stop. Do not remind me of the past long buried. Yes, I accept the blame. But maybe that is the way the Creator wants to bring us together. I love you. I never have the opportunity to love and be loved while I was alive. But that day, after you paid my bride price, my heart melted for you. And for the first time, I felt this beautiful thing called love. Please, Obin, I beg you, look beyond the physical and give me a chance in your life. Let's get used to ourselves and be happy. Just like every other couple out there.
God forbid bad thing. Not me and you.
I only agreed to pay your bride price because your father said that was the only way you were going to rest in peace. I did it so you could rest in peace and leave me alone. Not come into my house and try to torment me for the rest of my life. Leave me alone now.
I am sure Ivan MMC direct from the village. This thing that is happening to me, it is from the village. How can somebody ask me to go and lay a thread, then come back and he will give me 5 million bagam to start a business? 5 million naira! And I was there talking rubbish. No leva have now compelling man set. Hi! 5 million wife for collect by now for don't become millionaire. I was there talking rubbish. Siriaku, Siriaku, Siri. Ah, God. But wait. How can Ubiora tell me, Siriaku, says Bono Bruma Ivanalo, that he does not belong to a secret society? How come the ghost his wife saw in his house if he does not belong to a secret cult? And what kind of buying and selling will someone be doing in this country that will give him the kind of money Obiora has within a short period of time?
Obiora, you are not telling me the truth. You are obviously not telling me the truth. You don't want to let me into what gave you money. If you don't have to move now, but no problem. As I don't make up my mind, say I go join secret court. I go look for better secret court, enter. Use Eliza for sacrifice. They will not make it. Obiora, the next time you will see me, I go man and maybe take the New Testament.
Here before I went inside.
But he told me that I should come today and collect my money.
I don't know. It's already afternoon. He might have gone to work.
If he comes back, tell him that I'm coming back tomorrow to collect my money. And if he fails, I will not only seize his property, I will lock him up in the cell.
Okay, sir, I'll find you.
Promise.
The only difference between us is my body, which I no longer wear. Please, I beg you again, look beyond the physical and give me a chance.
Please, I beg you, Nkem. I am begging you for my own part. Leave me alone. I don't love you and I will never love you. Just leave me alone. Go away.
Break our bond, and I will gladly leave.
What bond? What bond, Kwapiko? What bond?
The bride price. Retrieve it from my father. And I will be out of your life completely. But before you do that, I would like you to know that I am the source of your wealth. And I shall leave with everything I brought into your life. All the wealth. And you shall return to the dust of poverty where I picked you from.
You lie! You're not the source of my wealth! I won't believe your lies!
So you have forgotten how wretched and miserable you were before you paid my bride price. Obiora, you think the sudden influx of wealth into your life was mere coincidence? Obi, I fought. I wrestled with spiritual forces and separated you from the curse that kept you in abject poverty. I paid the price for your financial freedom because of the bond holding us together. If the bond be broken, the price will lose its efficacy and the curse of poverty shall return. The ball is in your court. Make your choice.
Why don't this one want to leave me alone? What did I do? What did I do to allow this kind of torment in my own house? Forgive me, people, forgive me.
Where is your father?
He died a long time ago.
Only your father can lift the curse if Ijumwa drops it. But now that he's dead, no one else can lift the curse if she drops it.
I cannot go back to poverty. Onunelele adromeya, you are adigum committed already.
At the same time, I need a woman in my life. I need a woman to bear me children and perpetuate my name when I'm long gone. I need a family to enjoy all this wealth with. There's no sacrifice or anything I can render to make the gods fight this for me.
I'm sorry. No sacrifice. You have to choose between the two options. Live without a woman and remain rich. Break the bond and go back to poverty. Nothing else can be done.
Wetin they do you self? And they tell you say they sick, you they talk of money. Eh? Which girlfriend for this world they treat in boyfriend as you take the treatment now? Eh?
But wait, which boyfriend go even think say he go borrow money from in girlfriend? He no go like pay. Pay me my money now. I they give you as you want. So if you borrow money from me, you pay me.
I go pay you. I go pay you, but pay I me. Beg, no be today. Hey, make I just carry this small change, go buy medicine, drink. Tomorrow I go give you your money. Now, tomorrow I go give you.
You sure?
I go give you. I go even buy you bling bling John on top.
Like, you serious? No. You change my shoe.
I go do am. I go do am. Make I just the work. I beg. I know.
Make I love you. But anyway, Shara, your side I dey go. But I say, since I don't meet you here, I still go back where I'm from. Come. May not be like say I dey disturb you. I'm going back. Oh. Just be careful. Give me my money tomorrow.
Oh my God. Nah. Nah. Which kind of man being be this? How take me this nonsense girl? How take me this to be girl now? Oh my God. Go show me your court temple where I feel sacrifice this girl make money. Ha! This girl just disturbance to my life.
How do I explain this? What do I tell the world? How do I bear this shame? Returning to poverty after tasting such massive wealth? Returning to a nobody after commanding such affluence? No. This can't be. But what use is wealth without a family to enjoy it? How do I raise offsprings to sustain my lineage without getting married to any woman? What becomes of my name when I die? What reason will I give the world for not getting married? This is serious. I want a family, a happy home. And I also don't want to go back to poverty. How do I get out of this dilemma? How?
You're welcome, my husband. You are thirsty.
I am not your husband. Why can't you leave me alone? Leave me alone!
I have done nothing wrong other than love you. All I ask is for you to love me back.
I don't. I can't and I will never love you. In fact, I hate you.
Why keep me here when you don't want me? Break our bond and I will go to the world beyond and rest. Why tie my soul to yours when you hate me this much?
Your father lied to me. He did not explain all these things to me. That guy came along this thing of Fuma. Leave me alone.
Now you know. Go and retrieve the bright prize. I want to go. I am tired of your hatred.
Sorry.
Rushed her to the hospital immediately. I was confused. I didn't know what to do. I didn't know how to contact anybody who knew who she was. Fortunately for me, a call came into her phone. I picked and it was her father. I told him what happened, and in no time he was at the hospital.
Doctor Harris, my God!
Let's see in my office.
I don't have time for the office. I want to see my daughter now. I'm here.
Well, I'm sorry, sir. Did our best. But we lost her.
What? You lost who?
Come on.
He got me arrested and locked me up in a police cell. After a few days, he came back for me. He bailed me out and even drove me himself to my house.
Please, I want you to understand that what I did down there was out of hand. And it is not easy to lose anything. The most annoying part of it is that she was still graduated from the university last 2 months. So, her part was not that easy.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry about it. I wish there was something I could do to reverse this whole situation.
Is it clear what has happened is happening? Blaming yourself will change anything. To say the truth, it was not your fault. So, and you know, you tried your best to sit up, to stand the chance of you. So it is not yourself, your fault. Stop blaming yourself. Now I know where you stay. It's as easy as coming.
Thank you. Thank you for driving me. God bless you. Shall take care of you.
Stop telling me this thing you're telling me. How does it even sound to you? I should go and pay the bride price of a dead person. Fine, I know I caused her death, but it was an accident, and you know that. So this one will not work. Honestly, it will not work.
My brother, I am not forcing you. I'm only begging you.
It's just to present small money that will cover our car.
And I am begging you to stop begging me. What is all this one, Kwano? How do you even do that? I should go and pay the bride price of a dead person. Maybe I can't remember that one. And I could go issue them around. I cannot do this, so I can't.
I'm not saying that you should pay for a dead person. But what I'm saying is that you should present small money to cover up for her bride price. Something that would have been done if she were to be alive. You know, it's going to be very dangerous to you if this thing is not done. And her spirit will begin to chase everybody, even the entire family and the village.
So what if I had run away when I knocked her down? Who would you have held to come and pay her bride price?
Nobody. But I mean, just like I've just said, it will be very, very disastrous and dangerous. Her spirit will not rest at all.
That is your village. In my village, you do not pay the bride price of dead people. Leave me alone, Biko.
I wish you understand that this is a tradition.
It is not our tradition in our place. I cannot pay the bride price of a dead person. That is the point.
The issue lingered for days. Arguments upon arguments, they just went on and on. The father had to involve his kinsmen and even the community. At some point, the pressure was so much, I had to succumb. I paid her bride price. I did it because I wanted her to rest in peace. Instead, she began to follow me. She began following me everywhere. I didn't even realize she was following me until a few days ago when she appeared to me in this house.
This is serious.
She said the only condition she would leave me alone to be in peace is that I go and collect the bride price I paid on her head.
Then go and take the bride price.
He says she's the source of my wealth. That if I took back that bride price, I'll go back to abject poverty.
I do not believe her. That's a lie.
I met a spiritualist who confirmed exactly what she told me. That if I collect that bride price, I would go back to abject poverty. She told me if I want to remain in wealth, I should never get married.
That's a lie. That's a lie from the pit of hell. Nobody, not even a ghost, will take my husband or his wealth away from me. Honey, listen to me. Listen. I know the God I am serving. There is absolutely nothing to be afraid of. Okay. There is nothing to be afraid of.
Great one. Okedi Biobu Odado. This is the picture of the girl I want to use for the money ritual.
This person is empty, eh? Very, very empty. Her destiny has been used by someone else long ago. Yes, and the thing they used her to do is so powerful that any man who sleeps with her becomes as useless and as empty as she is.
Hey!
Oh yes! She is a channel through which that occultic kingdom steals the destinies of men. Once you sleep with her, you are finished.
I am finished. I am finished.
Yes. From what I can see, young man, you are truly finished.
Listen, Liam. What am truly the Bulugunzo Liam? Hi! Onion Cholili! The Bulugunzo Liam Fitono! Hi!
He cut short my life, yet I loved him and gave him my all. I wrestled with spirits and deities for his freedom. Now that he is free, he thinks he can throw me into a trash just because of him.
Please don't hurt me. Please don't hurt me.
I have warned you over and over again, but you refuse to heed my warning. This is the end of the road for you.
Please don't hurt me. Please. Need to go and retrieve that bright prize so that it will break whatever bond you have with that evil spirit. Please, my love, please. Please.
It's okay. I will. Okay? Let's go back to bed.
and sleep.
Try and sleep. Never go back to poverty. I refuse to. But how do I wriggle myself out of this dilemma? How?
To go to that girl's village to retrieve her bride price.
Yeah, I know. But I changed my mind.
You changed your mind? But we had agreed on that last night.
Yeah, we did, but I changed my mind. I need some time to think about it.
You chose her over me. You chose a dead girl over me.
Have you ever experienced poverty? Of course, no. You were born with a silver spoon. If you know what it means to live in abject penury, you wouldn't advise me to go take back that bride price.
God still blesses. God still blesses. God can still bless you. Let her go with whatever she claims she brought you so that God can give you true riches. Darling, listen to me. The blessings of God maketh rich and addeth no sorrow.
Where was God when I was suffering? Where was he when I was living in abject poverty? When I was hawking the whole street under the scorching sun? Where was he when I had nothing to feed on? When I almost died? When I was accused wrongly as a taxi driver? Where was he when all these things were happening? Now, don't you ever bring that God story to me. Sit your butt down here and give me ample time to think about it and ponder how to go about all this.
God still blesses. He still gave true riches. She didn't bring all this. I know that my God will still bless you. He will still bless.
Pastor, these people have rendered me useless. Me, even Pastor.
The friend has been useless. I didn't know that my girlfriend, the girl I was sleeping with, is a channel through which occult men take other people's destiny. I didn't know. I didn't know. Elisa, you finished. Elisa, can you make it? Can you make it, Elisa? Can you make it, Elisa? Pastor, please. Please, I am begging you. Pray and deliver me from the shackles of this occult man, Biko. I promise you, if you deliver me, I swear, I will not follow women again. In fact, if I see women crossing, I will close my eyes.
It's okay, my brother. In the book of John, chapter 1, verse 12, it says that as many as receive him, to them he gave power to become the sons of God. And again, it says in the book of 1 John, that if we confess our sins, that is faithful and just to forgive us and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Jesus Christ is able to protect you. He will build a wall of fire around you. That's why he said in the book of Romans chapter 8 verse 1, that there is therefore now no condemnation to them that are in Christ Jesus. Let the occultic men do whatever they want. So long as you are in Christ Jesus, they can never get you again. And you said they've tampered with your destiny. Jesus Christ is the only destiny giver. He will rewrite your destiny, I assure you.
With a spoken word, he created the whole universe. And with a spoken word, I'm going to pronounce on you, your destiny will be revisited.
Amen.
And renewed.
Amen.
Are you willing to give your life to Christ?
Please, I am willing to give my life to Christ. I am willing.
Good. Now, I will lead you to Christ.
That's the dilemma I found myself in.
My brother, money is good, yes, but not to be compared with the joy of having your children around you. No matter how rich you are as a man, my brother, until you produce your own offspring, you are not considered a man in Igbo land. Ofwe Mankawa.
Are you the one saying this, Obusukwaga Onikuya?
Yeah. My brother, I choose to be poor with children than to be rich without children. Yes. Life without children is like a forest without trees. Yes. Your children are your security for tomorrow. They shall be your legs when your legs can no longer carry your body. They shall be your eyes when your eyes must have grown dim. They shall take care of you when you must have grown old. Above all, they will sustain your name here on earth and keep your lineage going after you must have joined your ancestors.
My brother, nothing, absolutely nothing, can be compared with the joy of having your own children. They buy you a wose. Mwakego, my brother. Yes.
Have you ever experienced poverty? Have you ever existed in abject penury? Have you thought about that?
My brother, you are still entitled to your own opinion. I'm telling you my own choice. Yes.
Thank you.
sure this is his.
Anybody here? Anybody here? Anybody here?
That's exactly what I saw today. As I'm speaking with you now, I don't know what else to do.
So, why was she pressurizing you?
to retrieve the bride price. When I believe she knows that her father is dead and there is no one to give it to you.
I don't understand. I honestly do not understand this.
I think it's high time we sought the face of God for His mercy and divine intervention. And we have to invite a pastor.
No. All those pastors are fake. No.
Allow me to invite mine. I believe God is going to fight our battle through him. Please, darling, please.
I've not seen any pastor. Know what to do.
Witches.
Return to the house. Take anything of value from the compound. Go to the man's grave. Tell him you're taking it in the place of the daughter's bride price you paid. Return with it to your home, and that dead girl's spirit will never appear to you again.
Thank you, Ezenwai. I will do as you have said.
Go in peace.
Yes, Pastor. I was praying last night. And while I was praying, the Lord spoke to me concerning you. Yes. The Lord said that all that the evil men have stolen from you, that he has restored them back.
Praise the Lord!
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
I will advise you to
is spiritual and prayerful as we await the manifestation of God's blessings.
I will, Pastor. I will, Pastor. Thank you, Pastor. Thank you.
It's okay. It's okay. It's God we should be thanking. We should be thanking God. Secondly, there's a vacancy in this church. Yes, the church wants to employ a driver, a personal driver that will be taking me around. So I don't know if you'd be interested. And the offer goes with free accommodation and monthly salary of 70,000 naira. So I don't know if you'd be interested.
So I can hold on to that as we, you know, look forward to the mega manifestation of his blessings.
Pastor, I'm interested. I'm interested, Pastor, I'm interested.
Sure.
Yes.
Then, the job is yours. You can start off tomorrow.
Pastor. Who would I have done on this thing?
Pastor. Don't kneel down.
What I do now, what I be?
No, don't.
Pastor, yes. Thank you. Thank you.
No, you should be thanking God. Please. Stand up, sit
Pastor,
down.
Pastor, who have been now? Who have been? Who have been waiting? I do, Pastor.
It's God. It's God at work. Please just sit down.
I know it's God at work. But the Lord used you. I know as
all praises and thanks should go to Him.
Pastor, who have been?
Chief, I am taking this bucket from your compound in replacement of the bride price I paid on your daughter's head. That's the condition she gave for her to rest in peace. And I am doing that for her to rest in peace because I know that her peace is all you have ever wanted, which was the main reason you asked me to pay her bride price. I have come to take this bucket and I have come to seek your permission. Please let me go peacefully with it. May your soul continue to rest in peace. Thank you.
It's the end of you.
Stop everything! Look at the way I'm breathing though. Mother, I'm gonna take you to the hospital. I told you, mother.
Mother, I'm gonna take you to the hospital. I can't
Oh, baby. I can't take you to the hospital.
Nothing will happen to you. So long as my God liveth, the God I serve. Obin, nothing will happen to you. Pastor, my husband is dead.
The devil is in life.
My husband is dead.
I am serving the living God.
Yes.
The God that called those things that be not as though they were.
Amen.
The God that defeated the devil on the cross of Calvary. The God that subdued principalities and powers.
Amen.
That is who you are, Father. The God that defeated principalities and powers.
Amen.
And subdued them and made a open show of them.
Yes, Lord. Yes,
Father,
Lord.
I'm standing on your word.
Yes, Lord.
Whose report shall we believe?
Jesus.
The devil has decreed death.
Yes.
But you said you have come that we might have life and have it more.
Yes.
Father, Lord. We are standing here, O Jehovah, according to your word that said that whatsoever we ask in your name, you will do.
Yes.
Father, as a church, O God, that power that resurrected Jesus on the third day is here.
Yes.
The power of resurrection is here.
Yes, Lord.
Father, at this juncture, I decree and I declare.
Amen.
Let that resurrection force permeate this body.
Amen.
I call back his spirit.
Amen.
God, you said even the lawful captives shall be set free.
Oh, yes.
Father, the accuser of the brethren cannot hold him bound.
Yes,
I lose him.
Yes,
I call back his spirit.
Yes.
Father, at this point, I decree.
Yes, Lord.
Let his spirit come back.
Amen.
Come back in Jesus.
Amen.
Come back to life in Jesus.
Amen.
Come back to life in Jesus.
Amen.
Come back to life in Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Help him up. Help him up.
Okay.
Yes, Father, we bless your name. We glorify you.
Okay.
We
glorify
you.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Can you see your
mama?
Osi your mama leo. Osi your mama. Osi your mama leo. Can you see your
mama?
Oh mama leo. Can you see your
mama?
Can you see your mama?
Mama,
oh, see your mama.
Abrodo Obiora, now that you have accepted Christ as your Lord and personal Savior, I want to assure you that you are now a new creature.
Amen.
All things have passed away, and all things are new.
Amen. In the course of our prayers, the Lord revealed to me that there was a curse placed on you by your father which was not reversed before his death.
Chisholm, why don't your father want to pay your school fees?
He said he doesn't have money and my mother is very sick.
I know your mother is very sick, but that is not enough reason for your father not to pay your school fees. I am supposed to send you back home now, but I will not. I am going to give you 3 days of grace. We which if your father do not pay your school fees, I am going to send you back home. Which means you are not going to write your promotion exam with your classmates. When you get home, tell your father all I have said. Do you understand what I'm saying?
Yes, ma'am.
Go back to your class.
What are you doing here all alone?
She's crying.
Chisom, why are you crying?
Oh, Chisom, I'm not going to write the promotion exam.
Why? Did you do anything to her?
I've not paid my school fees.
Then tell your father I should come and pay so that I can write the exam.
My father said I spent all his money on my sick mother.
I'm so sorry about that.
Huh? I want to write the exam. I don't want to repeat the class.
Just tell our teacher that your mother is...
Yes, but she said it's not enough for reason. And she also said that I have only 3 days to pay up, else I'll not be allowed to write the exam.
I'm so sorry. It's okay, stop crying. You will write the exam. Just pray. Pray that God will provide the money so your father will pay before the 3 days expires. It's okay, stop crying. It's okay, yeah? It's okay. Let's go to the class.
Here is the money. Don't pay it.
Who gave it to me?
My dad, but you see, I should not tell anyone. Miss Chisholm, don't tell anyone that I gave you the money.
Even our teacher or any of our friends.
Thank you. Thank you so much. God be blessed.
Amen. Amen.
Miss Chisholm, go now and give it to our teacher.
Chisholm, please
promise me that you won't tell anyone that I gave you the money.
I promise.
You want to pay your school fees? Why didn't your father come himself?
Because as he took my mother to the hospital.
Wait. Chisholm, you said your father gave you this money?
Yeah.
Are you sure that your father gave you this money?
Yes.
Chisholm, you are lying. Where did you get this money from?
My father gave it to me.
This money is far beyond the school fees. In fact, it's 3 times above the school fees. Tell me the truth. Where did you get this money from?
My father gave it to me.
Chisholm, if you don't want to tell me the truth, I will tell the headmistress and she will expel you from the school. Are you ready to tell me the truth? Where did you get this money from?
My father gave it to me.
Chisholm. Chisholm, who gave you this money? Where did you get it from? Chisholm, tell me the truth. Where did you get this money from? Chisholm, where did you get this money from?
No. Did you see the money I kept in the room? The money I was supposed to pay the laborers with.
I didn't see any money.
You didn't see any money? Yes, again. You didn't take it.
I didn't see it, not talk of taking it.
Then you did.
Ojo.
Nai.
Eh?
That means somebody entered this house while I went to see Mama Nkoli. Hey!
I am finished.
Biamaya, calm down. Ah. Calm down. Alepo na manyen. Have you searched everywhere in that room? and you didn't see the money.
Nice again. I have searched everywhere. I turned that room upside down and I couldn't find it. In fact, I brought out that money this morning, Jakam Guanya, put it inside nylon and kept it on the table in the room.
Let me understand you very well. Are you saying you left our house open when you went to see Mama and Colin?
No, I didn't lock it. I didn't lock it. I'm a Nando Shigabiepa. What do I tell the laborers? Give them my then I roll them. What do I tell them?
I'm still finding it very, very difficult to believe that somebody will step his feet into my compound.
Enter my house. Shall never be well with you. Whoever entered this house and took the money I kept, I curse you today. It shall never be well with you. Whatever you lay your hand to do will never prosper. You shall look for money and money will be far from you. You will struggle from morning to night, but you will get nothing. As far as you step your feet on the side of this ground, you will never get anything you desire in life. You will suffer all the days of your life.
Someone stepped into my compound. Someone had the guts to step into my compound to steal from me. This cannot happen. Amadi Ahuna Anokuya. Eh? Ghost of our land, Duna Anokuya. The son I speak to you today to act upon my word, carry out each and every word that comes out of my mouth.
He said,
so shall it be upon whoever that came to my house to steal the money in my house, who came here and insulted me. You will remain insulted for the rest of your life.
He said,
you will remain poor for the rest of your life. You shall never see anything good. Nothing good will ever come your way. So shall it be.
I have spoken and I have decreed. Let me see it not to come to pass.
He said,
don't worry. We will get to the end of this thing. Teacher.
What do you want to do with
Obiara?
Obiara! What do you want to do with
Obiara, is not going? Obiara! Ha!
We will.
Apocha, Makati.
We will. Hey! We will.
Obiara, we understand why you did what you did. But you must understand one thing. When someone takes what does not belong to him, that act is called theft. The person that did it is a thief. And that is exactly what you did. You performed an act of stealing by taking your mother's money and you did not tell her. So, you stole her money. Notwithstanding the intention. Yes. That was why your mother flogged you mercilessly in the afternoon. She did not flog you because she hates you, no. But because she dislikes that act. She despises stealing. She does not want to see you grow with such attitude. You know it's a very bad attitude. Do you want to become a thief? Good.
God. You must not have such attitude in you. And it must not repeat itself again.
Repeat the case. If he dares it, I have told him. And he knows that if you dare take what does not belong to you again, I will steal you alive. You trust me. You know what I can do.
Obiora, now apologize to your mother.
I'm very sorry. I never take what is not my thing.
Good. Ugomu, you've hurt him. Hmm? You need to forgive him.
I've already done that.
Actually, why I called all of us out here by this time of the night is because of what I want us to do. You know what we did. We placed a curse on the person that stole your money.
Yes.
We were thinking that it was an outsider. We didn't know that the person that did it belongs to us. The main thing here is that we need to reverse that course.
Exactly.
So, please, reverse that course. Place your hand on him.
Obiora, my son. You took my money without my permission. And now that you brought back the money, I will reverse the curse I placed on you. I nullify every curse I placed on you. It will not come to pass. It will not work. I nullify it. I nullify it. I free you from every curse. I cancel everything I said against you. It will not have effect on you. It will never have effect on you. The curse will not have effect on you.
And so shall it be.
And so shall it be.
Uh-huh. Good. Obiora. As your mother has forgiven you, I, your father, I have also forgiven you. All the curses I placed on you is hereby reversed. I will not only reverse them, but I am equally nullifying all of them. It will not have any effect on you. 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 You are free indeed from all the curses, my son. And so shall it be.
What are you doing here all alone?
I'm not going home.
Why?
How do I tell my parents that I failed again? How will I tell them that I will repeat class again? They will kill me for wasting their money.
They will not kill you. They are your parents. And I know no matter what happened, they still love you dearly. Bria, please, let's go home.
I'm not going home.
Let's go home, else your parents start looking for you.
Ngozi, what is happening to me? Before I should be the best student in our class, but now I am the worst. I always feel very sleepy whenever our teacher is teaching, and I don't understand anything she says.
I'm not happy you have to repeat one class 2 times. But you will not kill yourself. Just keep trying. One day everything will change.
We are please, let's go.
Thank you.
Peter, this one you can do. I have. I don't want you to do it. Okay, sit down. You are not used to eating cola nut. Should I buy?
No, don't worry.
So what is the problem?
I am here because of Obiora's recent performance in the class. A boy who used to be the best in the class is now the worst student so far. He sleeps during the lesson period. When you ask him questions, he cannot answer. This thing gave me so much concern to the extent I started a private lesson for him. But the more you teach, the worse he becomes. So I just came to know if he is sick or something.
I am worried. I am extremely worried because of my son's situation. He is my only son, and that is why I am concerned. The situation is getting out of control as I speak. Because you will ask my son Obiora to go and get something in the kitchen for you. He gets to the kitchen, he will break the bottle of oil in the kitchen.
Error.
Knowingly or unknowingly, I don't know. You will send him on an errand. He will not get there. He gets back home. Where is what I asked you to buy? He will tell you he forgot it.
Something is definitely wrong.
Tell me, where is it coming from? Where is this problem coming from? I am confused. He was never like this. Eh?
What's the problem? I think you take him to the hospital for thoroughly checkup. Just to check whether the brain is in order. Just to check the brain. If the brain is in order. So the brain have crack or something like that nature. No?
Teacher.
Just do as I said. Maybe God will help. With God, everything will be possible. I'll be going. Please, take good care of him. Please.
Thank you so much.
He is my best student, you know.
Thank you so much.
All right.
Son's condition is giving me so much concern. I am worried. And I have been thinking about it. I keep on thinking on how best to handle the situation. And I've come to a conclusion. The best thing we should do for him is to send him to Ebuka to learn carpentry.
Carpentry, Gini?
Carpentry. But you should understand with me. He's going to school is meaningless. He is learning absolutely nothing. Of what use is it to us or for us that we are spending money on him in school? Something we know that is not beneficial to him is not beneficial to us.
My son is too young to become a carpenter. Let us give him some time. He will still pick up in school. He used to be the best, you he remember? Used
he used to. Was. Past tense.
Okufegalaga.
I get him before no be property. Ugoma, I get him before no be property. Yes.
Biko. Nah. Biko.
Listen, let me tell you. I am not going to spend another dime on him in that school. I will not do it again. Okay.
Nai, please. This boy needs our support.
Eba.
Let us not abandon him now.
Who says we are abandoning him?
Let us give him a little more time. He will change. He will pick up.
Uh-huh.
You know how long we waited before we were blessed with this boy. No matter what, I still believe he is a special child. My people.
He is a special child. Agree. His own speciality is not in school. It's not everybody that was created that has the destiny to go to school or to attend school. No! There are people that were created to become mechanics. There are people that were created to become bricklayers. There are people that were equally created to become carpenters. Our soul here is obvious, can only survive with a handwork. So let him go and learn carpentry. If not carpentry, we can send him to Uche to learn car repairs and become a mechanic. What he needs is to have a handwork to secure a future.
This is interesting. It's more time.
You want to jeopardize his future?
Obiora, what is it?
Obiora, what is it?
I lost the money you gave me to buy
it.
You lost what? Where?
I went to Mama Chioma's shop and I couldn't find it again.
Look at the person you want to send back to school. He will go to school. He will lose the school. He will lose everything. You sold everything.
You are now a big boy. I'm so happy.
What is happening? Where is the money? Chimo, your pocket is torn. That means you lost the money. See, if you know what is good for you, go and look for my money or sister's servers. Is responsible for all that your son is going through.
What? My husband?
Yes.
How?
Your husband laid a curse on this boy. And the effect of that curse is what he is going through now.
We both lay curses on him. Our money got missing. We thought somebody came from outside to steal the money. So we cursed the person, not knowing it was her son. And when we found out, we reversed the curse. That same night, yes, that same night.
Yes, woman. All the curses were reversed that night. Except that which your husband spoke into the sun. And that can only be reversed before the sun. But all that you and your husband did was in the night.
Hey!
Now, where is your husband?
No.
We need to go and meet your husband now, before it will be late. Because your husband needs to stand before the sun and reverse all the curses he laid on your son. Let's go.
He's not there. I can't find him. It's like he went out.
Woman, prophetess, I need to see your husband here now. If not, there will be a very big problem.
Because what I am seeing in the spirit, no one can say it. He needs to be here now. Else, your son here will be doomed.
Hey!
Yes!
Nayo! Nayo! Hey! Nayo! What is it? Nayo! Nayo, get inside! What happened to my husband?
Stop! It's not very far. Don't know what happened to him. Yes, we were trying to wake him. He couldn't wake.
Nine. Hey. Nine. No. Hey. No. Vivo. Hey. Go in, Major. Go in, Major. Major. Oh. Vivo. Come on, come on.
By the reason of the prayers we've just heard here, the curse has been destroyed.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you very much, Pastor.
Secondly, the Lord revealed to me that there's a spirit threatening to take away all that you have and send you to abject poverty. The Lord revealed to me that your wealth did not come from her. All she did was to lift the curse over a period of time. And within that period, the works of your hands prospered. But right now, she has dropped the curse. But in the course of our prayers a few minutes ago, the Lord has destroyed the curse.
So you're free forever. Amen.
For whosoever the Son of Man shall set free is free indeed. Congratulations.
I promise to dedicate myself to the service of the Lord henceforth.
Amen.
And that I will do for the rest of my life.
Hallelujah. Obiora, my brother. Please, I am very sorry for mistaking you for an occult man. Please, find it in your heart to forgive me.
No, that is no problem. I understand. Anybody in your shoes who witnessed what happened would assume the same. I've forgiven you. And I will still redeem the promise of 5 million naira I made to you to start up a business.
Hallelujah. You will give me the 5 million.
Amen.
Praise the Lord!
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. Father, thank you for the manifestation of the promise you made to me. You are faithful, Lord.